We know so much about him. We've heard about him. But then, for us to experience all that we've heard, we will need to pray. We will need to cry out to him. When your mind is preoccupied with God, prayer is a natural response to such a heart. But when it is preoccupied with the world, prayer is far from that heart. It's not for God to dwell in your head. It's anatomy that wants to dwell in your head. Anatomy, physiology, microbiology, biochemistry, and all of that. That's what is meant to dwell in your head. God wants to dwell in our hearts. When it's time for the word of God, when it's time for prayer, that's when your mind wanders. That's when sleep, you know, you remember you've not slept. But when it's time to have, you know, maybe a gathering or whatsoever, that's when every of your senses are alive. Then now, that means the flesh is already gaining ground in your soul. You are beginning to live the life of the flesh. And I tell you, such state is not good for a believer. Jesus cried, and he was telling the disciples, watch ye. If you don't watch and pray, you will enter into what? Temptation. When the flesh is what begins to, you know, fleshly things and, you know, carnal things are what excites you, in no time you will fall into sin. I pray to not get to that point in the name of Jesus.